I'm gonna try and make this short and sweet. But here's today's energies for our full moon. So for our past energies, we have the hungry moon, we have the wolf, he's hungry. It's going to be a full moon tonight, we know that, so that's pretty awesome that that came out. But we're putting it in the past, and we are coming out the Nine of Pentacles here. The Nine of Pentacles, the reason we're coming out as the Nine of Pentacles, or what we're coming out from, is we are hungry for putting our heart and our mind together, right? Of course, that's what we're seeing there with the hungry moon. So it's no surprise that I see that in the past there. And that's from the Queen of Moon Oracle deck and spellcasters. So here we come into our current situation, a blessing from the fairy guardian. We're just being told here that we are being guarded in everything that we choose to do. We're being asked to go ahead and heal ourselves. You know, if it means closing your eyes to heal yourself, know that somebody is guarding over your heart and your everything. Like they're working in your best interest at this time. You've got the King of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles. Sorry, I know it's bent. I took this out with me one day and in my pocket, and it got bent. And it's never come out since then, so it's kind of cool to see it come out this time. The King of Pentacles is just saying that, you know, the fertility has been planted here again with the Nine of Pentacles. You know, you're reaping your rewards, you're ready to step up. So this is your past, and this is going into your future with the King of Pentacles. You're ready to reap those rewards, right? And again, we see the Knight of Pentacles. So the Knight of Pentacles is exactly saying the same thing. The brand new beginning is yours. Like, you just have to say, I accept and I receive. And you have to, tonight is a really great night with this full super moon to go ahead and say, you know what, I accept all the blessings that are owed to me, all the blessings that karma wants to give to me. And then we go into your future, and your future is, how teachable are you? Like, what are you willing to learn and accept to bring something into your life? Because if you're teachable enough, you have the Ace of Swords. And the Ace of Swords is saying, here's your fiery brand new beginning. Here's your clarity. Here's your everything that you ever wanted to see come to fruition. It can happen. Burn down the old belief system that you have. Like, open up to a brand new belief system that everything will be exactly as it's supposed to be for you, as the universe wants it to be for you. And walk away from anything that doesn't serve you. Yes, it's horrible to cut ties, and it hurts. I get that. But you have the fire of the Ace of Swords to help you burn that hurt away. It's hard to walk away from stuff, you know? But for your own good, how teachable are you? Are you ready to walk away? Are you ready to move on? You know, if you're not, you're just going to have to relive this lesson again. So in your future outcome, here we go. So we have the Queen of Swords, which I love. She's so sassy to me. Anyways, she's just kind of saying, you know what? I'm putting my foot down. I'm done dealing with the crap of the past. And so my next card, I got the Nine of Wands, and I was like, oh, that's kind of crappy. Why are we getting her with this? So I asked for a lot of clarification because I kept getting a lot of heartbreak. A lot of, you know, I got the Five of Pentacles. I got the Three of Swords. But it came out to, and if you see on the Three of Swords, like in each one, so it starts out gold. And then, you know, kind of like the earth thing, the mutation, muting the energies. And even in the Three of Swords, even though I think of the Three of Swords as heartbreak, those swords are coming out from the bottom, but the sun is at the top. Like, those swords are reaching for the sunshine, right? And the final clarifier card was the Ace of Cups. I mean, like, how can you get any better than that? It's just kind of saying, you're going towards this beautiful manifestation of letting the past go, cutting out the past with your Queen of Swords, cutting out the heartbreak, the headaches, the everything that didn't serve you to go to this Ace of Cups. And with the Chariot in your outcome, final outcome card, I mean, like, the Chariot is just saying, we're going to make this happen really fast. Like, it's no joke. Like, this is happening right now. Tonight, I would say, is a great night to do a salt and crystal bath. And let all of this go. Let this go. Let the hurt, the anger, the indecision go. Like, let it go. You know, do a salt and crystal bath tonight and let that Chariot just take you away into your destiny, because at the bottom of the deck here, look what we have. Oh my God, I just love this card so much. And you're hearing the messages, so you're probably hearing this in your dreams at night too. Messages or receiving messages, or throughout the day you're seeing numbers, you're seeing signs, you're seeing butterflies, birds. It could be so many things. Like in my backyard, I have a racer that comes through. It's a lizard, native to Virginia. You know, like little tiny things that come through that just let you know that, hey, you're on the right path, and here's my message for you. So when you see an eagle, a swallow, a robin, if that is your message for the day, please Google it and find out what is spirit trying to tell you. Like right now, I see that there are some kind of messages coming in for the collective, because we're hungry for them, right? We're hungry. We're ready for answers, right? So going all the way back into our past, we are hungry for answers, right? So we can get out of this situation and we can get out of this situation, okay? So blessings, love, and light to all.